Good afternoon and welcome to another episode of Hawk Talk. I am your host, Bryce Johnson, and today we are focusing on the Roger Williams cross country team. Right now I am joined by Grace DePalma of the women's cross country team. Later on I'll be joined by Connor Hayden of the men's team. And Grace, how are you today?
I'm great, Bryce. Thank you for having me on.
And we'll jump right into it. What was it about Roger Williams that made you want to come and run for the Hawks?
I've been coming to Rhode Island since I was a baby. My aunt lives in Portsmouth, and so actually my sister did look at Roger Williams. She's 4 years older than me, so I went on her tour when I was in like 7th or 8th grade. Didn't really think anything of it, but I came here to tour. It was the first school I saw junior year, and immediately I knew I wanted to be here. I wound up having to look at other schools just to like please my parents and make them know that I was looking at other schools as well, but I knew I was dead set on coming to Roger Williams, and I wound up touring here 6 more times just because I knew I wanted to be here, and so I just kept coming back for any reason I could. I went to every open house, every tour I could, and then I wound up messaging Coach Sean. I actually hated running in high school, and I wanted to quit so bad. Completely lost my love for the sport, but I just kind of wanted to meet with him and see my options, and he met with my parents and I and had a lot of the girls on the team come meet with me when I was a senior in high school, and immediately I felt very at home, and I knew he really cared about his athletes. So I decided I wanted to give running a second shot, and I definitely made the right choice with doing that.
Yeah, sometimes when you get to a school that you know you want to go to, it just clicks.
Absolutely. You just know.
Exactly. And you were named team captain this year.
Yes, I was.
What does that mean to you?
I think being a captain of a girls' team especially is like a very special thing to me. My teammates, I think that they are all such strong women. I think of myself as a strong woman because of my upbringing. My mother's a very strong woman. My sister is a very strong woman. So is my stepmother. And so to be able to bring out the best in all of my teammates, and I know all of us have that fire within ourselves, and we all strive for success and we'll settle for nothing less. So I want to be able to be a role model and motivate my teammates and help them reach that potential that all of us have. You know, so it's something that I definitely think is very special to me, especially because my teammates are my best friends. You know, I live with my other captain, Siobhan, and we've lived together for the past 2 years. They're really going to be my bridesmaids one day. So it's something that I think is like the best honor I could have at this moment.
That's really neat. Really interesting stuff there. And from your perspective, what has been the biggest difference this year in your team's preparation and training compared to previous seasons?
Well, I think just like any other team, COVID greatly impacted our season with our whole season being canceled. And especially with the nature of our sport being running, it's not like we can do drills and practice in pods and those kinds of things. All we can do is literally run. So we were faced with the option to either run with masks on, which is nearly impossible when you're running 7 miles, or run 20 feet apart from each other, which is very difficult for us because we use running as our time to be present with ourselves and just talk, and we see the prettiest sunsets and we tell each other stories and we vent and we talk about our days. So to be faced with these kinds of options has been very difficult for us. And so the team dynamic isn't quite what it was last year. The incentive to run is very difficult because we don't have races on Saturdays. So just like any other team, we're definitely struggling on the motivation aspect of things, but we're still showing up and doing our very best. And I know that our coach has been working tirelessly for us. Like, he wants us to have as normal of a season as we can, and ultimately he just wants us to be together. So we're just thankful to be together as it is. Obviously we've been greatly affected by COVID and everything, but we just are happy to be together and happy to be even able to run.
Yeah, for sure. And let's go back to last season. You guys won the Commonwealth Coast Conference Championship.
Absolutely. Represent.
What was that like for you?
Oh, that was like the best thing in the world, honestly. Like I said, I used to hate running. So with my teammates, all of us kind of, the year before, we weren't quite there. We had the team dynamic and we loved each other, but we didn't have the mindset that we did last year. And literally every single one of us stepped up to the plate and we just made it a point to work hard. And the cool thing about conference that day was, I mean, we did win by 1 point, but we earned it. Like, it wasn't one team had a bad day. We were the it team. It's usually UNE has a really strong team, really big team and great runners, and it just so happened that that day we were stronger, that they looked at us on the starting line and they could have been scared. I mean, the year before we were fourth place, so we really kind of came out of nowhere and we surprised ourselves, and that was just the best feeling in the entire world, you know. And even to just prove to ourselves what we could do, it was just like completely out of left field, and we knew that we earned it, and it was just, it was like so surreal for me.
Yeah, for sure. I remember back when I used to run cross country, my team won the conference championship my senior year. It was just such a great feeling, yeah. You know, as an upperclassman, having worked that hard and that long,
yeah,
to reach that, the top of that mountain.
Yeah, definitely.
And besides maybe the CCC championship, what is your favorite memory as a Hawk so far?
Oh, this is a tough one. So I would definitely say last year, my junior year. It had taken me, I think I hadn't PR'd since my sophomore year of high school. A PR is a personal record. So my sophomore year of high school, I ran a 5K in 20 minutes and 21 seconds. Or no, 20 minutes and 44 seconds. Sorry, everyone. And it took me until my junior year of college to break that PR. So until then, I was just in a slump. And I was running like 24-minute 5Ks. I just couldn't get myself on a good track again. And so last year at UMass Dartmouth, which is usually our first race to really kickstart our season with 5Ks, I PR'd running 20:21. And that was a great, great thing for me because it had been so long, like so long anticipated. Everyone knew all I wanted was a PR just to get myself in that groove again where I just loved running and I felt good about myself. And then last year at one race, I think it was October, I wound up PRing alongside Siobhan, my co-captain, who's also my best friend, and the two of us broke 20. She ran 19:31, I ran 19:32, and I think neither of us really expected that, but we just did it. And crossing the finish line, and it was just literally amazing. Like, I had chills. I saw the time and I didn't even believe it, and we hugged each other, and it was just like the best thing in the entire world. It was awesome. Like, those kinds of moments as a runner, I feel, separates us from other sports, because it's, as much as it is a team sport, it is also individual. And so to cross that finish line after all of those years of hating running and struggling with myself and my relationship with running, to be able to do that with my best friend was, like, amazing.
Now, you talk about how you struggled with your relationship with running for a while there, but how did you originally get involved in cross country?
I was actually involved in doing a lot of other sports growing up. I played lacrosse, basketball. Not saying I was good, but I did them. And then in eighth grade, my mom signed me up for rec cross country, and I just kind of did it. I mean, it was eighth grade, and I didn't even really, I would get ribbons, and I didn't know what it meant, but I just ran. And then I just kind of stopped. And then sometime in the winter of eighth grade, I went on a run with my mom, and she's really into health and fitness. And she looked at me and she goes, "Do you want to do a half marathon?" And I was like, "I guess." So then I ran my first half marathon at 13 years old. And then I did two others after that. And then after that, it was just kind of like, all right, you're just going to run cross country. And so I did all 4 years of high school and then all 4 years of college. It just kind of got into it that way.
That's fascinating, actually. Yeah. All right, some rapid fire questions. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right. Favorite course to run at?
Westfield State University.
Weirdest pre-race tradition you've ever seen?
So our captain for like 2 years, she just graduated last year, Sarah Maudsley, she's a beast, would only wear one pair of spandex, like a certain pair of spandex for races. So we get our uniforms from the laundry room, and if one person had, like, I think it had a certain number written on the tag, she would write in our group chat and be like, "Whoever has this spandex, switch with me," and she could only race in those. Only race in those, ever.
That's certainly bizarre.
Yeah.
Favorite meal from the calf?
Oh, steak. I could just devour 16 steaks. Just give me like 30 minutes, boom, down the hatch.
Favorite class you've taken thus far?
Probably my internship class. Being an educational studies major, you need two internships to graduate. So you have to take a class that coincides with them, and I took both of them with Dr. Susan Bascarelli. I love her. And it led me to my internship that I was hired for this past year, and I worked with them last year as well, working in a special education setting, which definitely like kind of solidified the belief that I want to work in special education.
That's awesome.
Yeah, thank you.
Finally, one thing that most people don't know about you.
I mean, I think a lot of people know this about me. I'm in an acapella group on campus. We're called Hawkward. It's a great group of people, but I come from a very musical family. My dad plays guitar, was always in bands growing up. My brother plays guitar. My stepdad plays the drums and the saxophone. I grew up playing piano and guitar. And I also was a theater kid in high school. So, like, I did a musical, and my only line in the musical was, "No coffee," but that was it. I was a theater kid. I did chorus, all of those kinds of things. So I definitely like to sing, you could say.
Nothing wrong with that. Thanks so much for joining us today, Grace. We got Connor Hayden coming on in a little bit for our special two-part episode of Hawk Talk. Till then, Bryce Johnson signing off.
Thank you, Bryce.
One of the captains of the Roger Williams cross-country team, Connor Hayden. Connor, how are you today?
I'm good. How about you?
I am fantastic. It's another beautiful day here in Bristol. You were named team captain this fall for the third consecutive season. What does that mean to you, being a captain for the third time?
I guess it's just really a big honor. It means that both my teammates and my coach have a lot of trust in me, asked me to come back another time. It means a lot because it's a big honor, really.
Now, as a captain, how do you feel your responsibilities have changed this year compared to prior seasons?
I mean, the season's unlike anything, really. I think it's really tough without having any meets or competitions. I think a lot of us have had some issues with just trying to keep motivated because it's tough when you don't have anything, myself included. But I think that's a big thing, is just making sure we're all still training in the hopes of having a spring semester and a spring season, and hopefully catching some other teams off guard.
Yeah, and as team captain, what are you doing to help the freshmen adjust to college during such crazy and uncertain times?
I think that's actually one of the awesome things, is this year we have a bunch of freshmen, and they honestly came in, and they're the ones whipping the upperclassmen into shape. They got some of us returners sweating a little bit because they came ready to race, which sucks not having a season because they would have had an awesome season. But I think the best thing that we can do as upperclassmen, as leaders on the team, is just make sure everybody's interacting with each other, that we still have that kind of team dynamic. It's tough with only a few practices a week, but I mean, we have like a fantasy football league with all of us, so, and we try and hang out in small groups, so we're all still getting to know everybody, and the freshmen get acclimated to the team so that by next year they're not going to feel like they're joining a team that year. They're already a part of the team.
For sure. It's an interesting time right now. And we'll take you back. When you were graduating high school and you're coming to college, what was it about Roger Williams that made you want to come and run for the Hawks?
Honestly, the ability to run here was kind of my deciding factor. School gave me the best opportunity to do so. So that was kind of made it break it. I could run for Roger, so that's why I came here.
Absolutely. And how did you get involved and start running cross country?
So I actually swam. I used to swim like back when I was younger. So my freshman year of high school, a bunch of my friends on the swim team were like, "Oh, we're like joining track in the spring. Like, you should come out." And I did. And like, I showed up one day to practice, and my coach was like, "Well, do you want to be a distance runner or a sprinter?" And I didn't know the difference between the two, so I said distance, and I kind of sealed my fate from there. I just kind of fell in love with it from that point.
That's actually really interesting. I ran cross country in high school and in middle school, and it was just something that I kind of like picked up. And yeah, it was like, you know, I just went and ran with it, no pun intended.
Yeah, I think everybody just kind of finds themselves in cross country. It just happens to you.
Yeah, absolutely. And what is your most memorable race in your cross country career so far?
Oh, I'd probably say it was conference championships my sophomore year. It was up at Gordon, and it was like in the middle of a huge storm, so it's like pouring rain the entire race, and like the entire trail is just all mud, and you have to do a few laps of it. So like, we were covered head to toe for like 3 hours afterwards by the time we got back home. So we were like nasty, but it was just a lot of fun because we had like a huge pack at the front. So like, I was running with my teammates the entire race, and we really were able to work together, and we managed to get like second that year, I think. So it was probably one of my most memorable and just the most fun races that we've had.
Yeah, and we were talking before we came on the air here today, and last semester you spent it abroad, mm-hmm. and you were in Ireland. Tell us about that.
It was awesome. I've always been really obsessed with Ireland. If you like, ask my friends, like that's one of my personality traits. It was really great having the opportunity to go over there. Well, I did. I got to run with the team over there too, so that was fun. Just kind of seeing how other schools from other countries kind of do the same thing. So that was just a cool opportunity, and it was just an awesome experience.
What was your favorite memory there?
I don't know. Probably I went to like the Cliffs of Moher like my first weekend there with a bunch of my friends, and it was like, again, it was like super rainy and just kind of like gross, but it's just really awesome just seeing all that. It's very like beautiful landscape, and like that's the entire country, so
that's awesome.
Yeah,
sounds like a great time. Now we got some rapid fire questions. You ready? Favorite course to run at?
Probably either Westfield or Bowdoin up in Maine.
All right. Favorite college pastime?
Ooh. I really like hammocking at the Shell Path when the weather's nice here at Roger. That's fun.
Seems to be a common answer. Favorite pre-race music?
So it's actually really not much of a hype song, but I kind of have a tradition from like high school or before every race. I listen to Stairway to Heaven by Led Zeppelin. So,
a classic. I dig it. Favorite hangout spot on campus?
Besides just Bayside, because I live there, probably the Shell Path again.
Okay.
We'll like get a bunch of hammocks down there, so it's that's pretty fun.
And what is one thing most people don't know about you?
Oh, I'm from Rhode Island. I kind of feel like that not a lot of people here at Roger are. So.
Fair enough. That works. Once again, Connor Hayden, thank you for joining us today. And your host, Bryce Johnson, signing off.